All right, so let's talk about this idea of scope. Scope in programming has to do with what can see what, or what can be seen by what. If we look at public class, and we'll just do scope fun. Public static void main string args. And if I have a simple method that wants to, I don't know, determine whether a number is odd. Okay, so I'm going to create a little method to determine if a number is odd. Then what I'll do is come in here and say public, and I'll need it to be static in this case. And then I'll call, and then it's going to return whether it's odd or even, so that'll be a true or a false. And if the method is odd, then it'll return a true if it's odd, or a false if it's even. So I'll just say a boolean is what I want to return, right? And then I'll call this method is odd. Okay, so we want to check to see if a number's odd. Well, in order for us to be able to check it, they're going to be able to need to pass us in a number to be able to use this method. And so if I say I want to have an integer passed in, and that int's just going to be a number. And then what's our logic for that? Well, we're going to create a Boolean variable called odd and set it equal to false initially, because we've got to set it equal to something, right? And then we'll say if that number that's being passed in, so the num that's coming in through this parenthesis, modulus by 2 is not equal to 0, or better yet, we probably could say equal to 1. So if that comes back and it's equal to 1, then we are going to set our odd variable to true because we found that it's an odd number, and now we can return odd. So is that making sense? So they're going to pass us in a Boolean. Sorry. They're going to pass us in an int called num. And then we're going to return a Boolean saying whether this number's odd or even. We start out with this little Boolean variable that's going to keep track of whether it's odd or not. And then we do the check. If it's odd, we're going to set it equal to true. And we know that because any number, if we take a 3 and modulus by 2, we're going to get a remainder of 1, because 2 goes into 3 one time with a remainder of 1, right? And that means it's odd. And so we'll return whether it's odd or not. Okay, so if I say here, system.out.println, and I'll call that method is odd, and I'll pass it the number 3, just like we did. Okay, and so that's going to print a true or a false based on the outcome. So I'll go ahead and save this. And it says that's true. It is odd. That is an odd number. And so if I do a 4, try running this again, then that will say false. Okay. Well, so this is the point I wanted to get at. What if I want to access this number? Or better yet, let's do this. I'm going to create an integer here and call it number and set it equal to 5. Okay, and then instead of doing an actual number here, I'll type in number. So we'll pass it a variable instead, which will be interpreted. And that's a true. Well, what if I decide down here in my isOdd method that I want to print out that number before I do any check on it? So I'm going to say system.out.println, and I want to print the number variable. Well, when I do this, it's going to give me an error saying I cannot find that symbol. And I get a little bit frustrated. I'm saying I declared it right there, but what's the problem? The problem is that this variable lives and dies between these braces. That's the scope of the variable. Okay? Does that make sense? And so it can only be seen by the main method. I don't know why I've had this thought going through my head since the very beginning of this discussion. And when I first said something about only being able to see, or what's able to be seen by what, and it immediately draws me back to The Sixth Sense. Great movie, right? And the little kid saying, "I see dead people." Right? He could see them, but nobody else around them could see him. Those dead people were in his scope, but they weren't in other people's scopes, right? This variable can only be seen, and in fact, in the movie, weren't there other people that could also see dead people? Wasn't that the whole Donnie Wahlberg thing at the beginning, that he could see them too? Anyway, so if I compile this, it's saying I cannot find that symbol because it doesn't belong to this method, right? It belongs only to this method up here. We could look at the same thing. I'll go ahead and leave that as is, but I won't print it out because I can't access it. It's the same thing that sometimes people will have this tendency to declare a variable. Instead of declaring this Boolean odd equals false, they might do something like this. Boolean odd equals true there, else Boolean odd equals false. Okay, so we're doing the same thing, but what they're doing is declaring this Boolean variable inside the if statement. Now, if I compile this, I'm going to get another error message saying, I cannot find this symbol. I have no idea what this variable means because it was declared inside the scope of this if statement. If it's declared inside this scope, it lives and dies within this scope. That's the only thing that can see it. And so when we get down to this line, it's already gone out of memory because it was only meant to be here, right? And so we need to declare it outside to where we want it to be seen by. We have to keep that in mind. Who do we need to see this variable? And then we can define it that way, right? Okay, so we'll put this back, Boolean odd, and set equal to false to begin with. And it probably would have been good to have this if-else in there anyway, just in case to check. Well, it's just an else, so that probably wouldn't be as effective as if we said if, well, either way, it really doesn't matter because it's just going to default. It's got a false in there. That's the problem with Boolean variables. It either has a true or a false in there. So you just have to be careful when you're looking for possible errors with those. Anyway, so what if I did have a variable that I wanted to be seen by both of these methods? What can I do? Well, the answer is I can come up in the class level, so before I do anything with methods, I can declare a variable. Now, it's going to be a public variable. Well, it might be a public variable. Actually, we probably want it to be private, but we'll talk more about that in a minute. But just for now, it's going to be a public static variable because it's going to be used by that this main class. This is all kind of in one. This we're getting into kind of more advanced topics here, but for now, so public static, and then I'm going to name the let's say a string name here and set it equal to blank. Well, that variable now has been declared at which scope? It's at the class level, right? So that means anything in the class can see it. So if I come into this method and I say I want a set name, well, let me do this. Because I like to have my variables declared first. So I'm going to set the name equal to, what was that kid's name? Dead people kid. I can only think of his real name. What was his name in the movie? Isn't it Haley Joe Osment? Is that his name? Okay, I got to look this up quick. Pause. All right, I'm back. It is Haley Joel Osment. I was right about that. And his name in the movie is Cole. Okay, so Cole. Whoops. Cole. Whoa. Cole. So that's the name that we're putting in, right? And now if I come down into this method, if I want to print out that name, system.out.println, whoops, I don't want to print Cole, I want to print the name, right? So if I compile this and then run it, then notice it prints out the name just fine. We no longer have this problem of cannot find symbol because the variable was declared at the class level, meaning anything in the class can see it. Now another class can't see it. Actually, it can because we made it public, so they can actually go in and access it. But it lives and dies inside this class. As soon as this class is out of memory, that name variable is gone. Okay, so what determines the scope? It really is, what braces is it between? If it's in an if statement, it will live and die within that if statement. If it's in a method, it will live and die within that method. And if it's in, at the class, it will live and die within that class. And then it will be seen by Cole because he can see dead things. Okay, that was really stupid. All right, so hopefully this idea of scope makes sense because it's going to become important as we now move into talking about kind of more advanced topics like object-oriented programming. Okay? Spencer, out.